So you've been hearing for a long time, maybe your whole life, about the value of being positive rather than negative, the value of having positive expectation, the value of looking in the direction of what you want, that it feels so much better to feel good than it does to not feel good. And yet you train yourself all day, every day as sort of realists. You train yourself as realists. You say, I should face reality. And if you ever aren't facing reality, if you should ever hear us and look to your vibrational reality, we call it your vortex. So important that you accept its reality, that we've named it, wrote two books about it. We want you to accept this as real. But as you maybe try to do that, and others around you who don't understand that they are vibrational creators, or that you are either, who don't understand about the vibrational realm, who don't get it, that all things come from thought, and thought is about vibration, and with enough momentum and alignment of thought, then those thoughts turn to things, that's how creation happens. So those that don't yet know that, watch you in your dreaming, or in your imagining, or in your being positive for no good reason, and they say, you need to get real, you need to be realists, you need to face reality. And we say, you didn't come to face reality, you didn't come to regurgitate reality, you came to create your own reality. You came to believe it into being. But as humans, you say, well, I'll believe it when I see it. And we say, that slows you way, way down. Because you can believe what you see that others have created, but then you just feel competitive, or you feel inferior. You say, well, they've created that, but I have not, therefore they must be superior in some way. Or you get resentful of what seems to be their magical path, their inheritance, or their good luck, or their good fortune, or their being born under the right star, or whatever silly thing you make up to explain why they're getting what they want and you're not getting what you want. But there is only one reason. If you're looking at what is, you're not able to move past what is. And please do not misunderstand us. We think that what is a wonderful thing. We think you're all standing in this wonderful, wonderful place, but we want to call it the bouncing off place. We want to call it the platform from which you allow more and more and more and more and more. And because we know the true nature of who you are, we know that you will not be happy unless you are allowing the more and the more and the more. When your mother, who really thought that she was the vortex through which all your well-being would flow, was pinching it off for herself and for you, and she saw you asking for more than she thought she could provide, she called you greedy. She said, you never get enough, do you? And you knew that the right answer that she wanted was, sorry, but that's not the answer that we want to hear from you. If someone calls you greedy, you want to say, yeah. Not greedy in the sense that I want more than I deserve. Not even greedy, because greedy sort of is a stinky word. I am expectant of a continual stream of well-being in all manner of abundance to flow into my experience, because that's who I am and that's why I came. And I was born, this is you talking, I was born into an environment of extraordinary contrast and balance. And out of it, I can choose for me what I prefer. And when I do, no matter how big or small or subtle or bold my launching of that rocket of desire is, my inner being then rides that rocket and becomes the vibrational equivalent of it, and never looks back at what was before it became. My inner being keeps up with the expansion that I discover here in my environment. And that is the reason that I feel negative emotion or positive emotion. Because when I keep up with the expansion, I launched the rocket and my inner being said yes. And my inner being knows the fullness of it. And law of attraction goes right to work on gathering the cooperative components. And so what I've asked for is in a state of real becoming. This is the evolution of all species, and you don't have a long enough memory to know how much has been accomplished here in physical form, but we want you to know that all of the hopes and dreams and wishes of all humanity and beyond are focused here. This is big time creation. This is the leading edge of thought. All eyes are upon you, not in the sense of judgment, but in the sense of helpful flowing. And you get to be or do or have whatever it is that you choose. But you got to do more than choose it from a place of not having it and then complain that it still hasn't come. You got to give that up. Once you choose it, you've got to start to believe it. You've got to know it. You say, well, I'll believe it when I see it. And we say, you got to believe it before you see it. You got to see it. And in time, you will believe it. You got to see it. And in time, everyone will believe it because it has manifested in a way that those who don't know how this works can then see it. Those who need this, see it, hear it, smell it, taste it, touch it proof will then say, oh yeah, you did good on that. But you've got to know how good you're doing even before it manifests. And most important, you got to enjoy the becoming of it. You say these words in other ways. You don't usually mean these words. Enjoy the journey. What you really mean is, give me the manifestation of my journey. Enough of this damn journey. Been on this journey for a really long time. I'm out of gas. I don't want any more of the journey. I want to be there. And we say, then you got to feel good, which means you got to get out ahead of it. You got to get out ahead of where you are. You got to get out ahead of it vibrationally. You got to get out ahead of it emotionally. You got to be happy in the becoming of it, not because of the becoming of it. You got to have your happy juices flowing, which allow your connectivity, your receptivity, so that your impulses then lead you to the unfolding of it. Yeah? We are eager to visit with you about anything that matters to you. There is not anything that is off limits in this discussion. What do you want to talk about? Some things. All right. Standing on your chair does not help. We can feel you. You light up. We can see the clarity of your desire, which is important to the discussion, because being clear is good for this discussion. And being in a vibrational proximity to what you want is a big help too, because that means we won't be struggling here. It means that you'll be ready to receive the insights that we're able to offer to you. You sort of get what we mean? If you want something and you're really in a lot of pain about it, then we can offer a lot of helpful processes, but you can't hear them. So take it easy and trust. Stop that. Take it easy. The reason we say that, someone is pointing at someone else. Pick this one, pick this one, pick this one. As if you don't believe in this one's ability to do her own attraction. You are a loving, lovely friend who wants so much to help those around you. But cut it out. Because what you actually say is, I do this for you because I see that you do not have the power to do it for yourself. There's so much of that that goes on in this teaching community. What you really want to know is that it's attraction, 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 attraction. Don't look to others to help you out because they can't vibrate for you. And don't look to helping others out in that way. Just believe in them. Believe in them. That's the most important thing that you can do for anybody. Is just believe in them. We know you're being playful about it. And it did get our attention, but we're not ever going to call on her now. All right. I can feel you out there. There you are. Right here.